For as long as I can remember, there have always been a clamor for the change of the education system. I mean, ever since I knew how to read and write, I will see politicians and government people and people in the private sector and all these guys in the NGOs talking about changing the education system in Kenya. And then you go to Uganda, it's basically the same thing. One country is applying one system, another is applying another system, and so on. But if you put all those systems together, you get one thing which is academic-based, and it's based on answering questions, you know, for 5 minutes, 1 hour or something, to pass an examination so that you can become competent, deemed competent. But then all those things that we go through and we come out of it, you ask someone at the end of the day, what next? They're going to tell you that what they're looking for is a job. So the question is this, is the change of curriculums, is it the same thing that we need to do today? Is it the answer? Let's stay tuned and listen.
Welcome to the Life Signatures podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Again, let me go back to what I've just been sharing over and over again, that you can have structures in place. And I know they normally tell us that, you know, culture eats whatever for breakfast. Culture eats what? Culture eats strategy for breakfast. That's a very valid point to note. And I think it's Peter Drucker who said that stuff. And look at the same thing that we're applying in the education sector, in raising our children. And you know, when you talk about education sector, the first thing that comes to people's mind is schools. In other words, we've been so ingrained in a starter school, in the culture that says that school is something that is away from home. It is away from the family. I mean, education is something that is, you know, involving going to a particular system where you can be able to be competent and answer questions and pass exams and get fitted, you know, get a certificate, a diploma, and so on. And I remember very well going to Uganda and training very many people on one thing or another. And I was shocked that every time you train people on something, they come and ask you, is there a certificate? Are you going to issue us with certificates? I mean, people are so elevating certificates as if it's the holy grail of achievement. And so you go for interviews. I mean, you hold interviews and someone comes with a battalion of certificates. They have done this certificate and this certificate, this diploma, this degree, this. I mean, certificates upon certificates. And you're not looking for academics. You're not looking for people with brains to do academics. You're looking for relevance. You're looking for someone who can solve a problem, someone who can apply themselves passionately into the relevance that you have at that moment, in the context that you have at that moment, and solve for you a problem. That's what you're looking for. You're not looking for someone who has, you know, the most knowledge in this and the most knowledge in that. And I know knowledge sometimes is important because it can be applicable and so on. But let me tell you this, when you are given a responsibility to work, for the most part, they're going to train you. I mean, let me tell you this, at the end of the day, can you reason? Can you read? Can you write? Can you think outside the box? Not do you have a degree and so on and so forth. Unless, of course, those technical jobs like electronics and, you know, telecommunications and so on. But at the end of the day, for the most part, where the rubber meets the road is, can you read, can you write, can you think? That's it. Can you be a self-starter? Can you apply yourself? And so we think school is just about going somewhere outside of the home and spend days or maybe decades out there trying to cram some things and put them in our minds and so on and so forth. And no wonder people come out of school and they remain jobless and they remain irrelevant. And the things that they used to do, I was just sharing with my wife this morning that there's a guy who is doing food. I mean, he's foodious. I mean, he loves food. He sells food. And this guy has certificates, degrees and so on in mechanical, in electronics, whatever it is, and computers and so on and so forth. I get my point. My point is that at the end of the day, you will say, let's change the curriculum all you want. But if the insight behind that is not going to be changed, you will be changing it all over the place. There's a guy, the alumni in my school, we left school in 1996, and so we formed the group and we were just discussing and so on. And so someone was talking about the school system and saying that, you know, the school system should only, you know, apply, enroll this kind of guys and so on. And I told him, this guy, that if you're going to start selecting people that should be enrolled in the school system, it has failed already. I mean, we should have a system where every single person, whether they're academically gifted, sports gifted, they are good in the head, good in the hands, good in the heart, whatever, everyone should have access to school, you know, not just those guys who are smart upstairs. That's how that's where the problem is. And that's why I'm telling you, if we're going to have a solution to this conundrum, we are going to go back to the cradle, where the cradle is the home. The home that is where you and I can be life coaches to our kids. And we can tell them how life works. Let them know their purpose. Let them know what they are gifted at, what they are good at. And try to teach them. Not even try. Just teach them from home how to become relevant in life. Start looking at life in terms of, I am a solution provider. I am a problem solver. I am a guy on a mission. I'm a lady on a mission. I am a person with purpose. I've been given the tools. And the tools are my gifts and my talents and my brain and my thinking and my passion. That is what I'm supposed to apply in life, to look at what problems are there and start solving those problems as I go. That is where the answer is. And I'm not saying this is the silver bullet. I'll say this until I'm green in the face. The answer is not a silver bullet. There are very many answers. That means that the guy who is going to school and is actually acing his papers and so on and so forth, and is doing engineering, is becoming a doctor, it works for him. Yes, let it work for him. But then there is a guy who is not academically gifted, but is gifted in something else and is passionate about it. Let him go there also and let him be excellent in it and let him be mentored in it. That's why I'm telling you, you've got to be a life coach as a parent in the home. If not, then we're going to have a problem, even as we continue to say that let's just change this system, let's change the academic systems and so on. You'll be mistaken. What change are you enacting if all that you are changing is the content of the academic subjects? What change are you enacting if all that you're changing is, you know, the mode of delivery? What if you're not changing the insight? And this is the insight that I'm saying. The insight is that everyone has a place in society. It is not survival for the fittest. I don't think that God created people to be survival for the fittest. God created everyone to be useful, to be on a mission, to be having a purpose, to have a difference, uniqueness, and so on, and to bring those things, to be the most glorious versions of themselves. And that does not delegate, that does not remove anyone from the equation. Everyone is involved. So if you're changing the curriculum of the school, it has, at the end of it, have an insight into everyone. And that's why I'm telling you, you've got to start it from home as a parent, discipling these people and so on. And I've written a book towards this. The book is called Purpose to Profit. And you can get it for free from lifesignatures.life/purpose to profit. And you can read about this, where I'm telling you that it is not just jobs that are answers. It is these gifts, these talents that you've identified as a parent at home that can be monetized. It's a process that you can go through and you can monetize these things. I am saying this because I am living it. This is not theory. This is practical. This is working for me. This is working for very many other people. And some of my mentors are doing this, especially in this day and in this age. The world has changed so much so that you can have people earning money on Instagram, earning money on YouTube, earning money on LinkedIn. You can have people doing what you call the gig economy. You do a gig here. You can go to Upwork and down upload your work there, and you can bid for many jobs and so on. The world has changed. Jobs are not the silver bullet. They're not the only answers. That's why you've got to look at how you can monetize your gifts and your talents, especially for those kids. We all know that academic prowess alone is not the holy grail of achievement in society, and it's not the only thing that the world needs. The world needs every individual who is unique to apply themselves. And so what you and I need to do as parents is to start discipling our children, to start being life coaches in the home. See, if we don't do that, I guarantee you, if we don't do that, you'll keep sending your kids to school. And the thing has changed. The system has changed. The world has changed. But the school system is still intact. I mean, they're saying let's change, and they're doing some cosmetic changes. There is no fundamental change. Groundwork has not been done to change, overhaul the whole system. It is just change in theory. We load those changes, yes, but they're not enough. If you're not going to disciple your child as a life coach from their home, they're going to get into trouble. We want children that are solution thinkers, problem solvers from the get-go. Not waiting until they have graduated from university and then they start thinking, what project can I do? What job can I apply? No. These kids have been as they go. In fact, even many organizations are changing the way that they are recruiting. They are not necessarily recruiting people who have degrees and so on. They are recruiting people who can solve problems, think outside the box, be a self-starter, lead themselves, and so on and so forth. I'm going to continue with this, but I'm urging you, go to that website, lifesignatures.life/purpose-to-profit, and get yourself a copy of that book, limited time only, because it's going to be sold after that. But also, I challenge you to become a life coach. Until next time, just tomorrow, bye-bye and stay tuned. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.